evening. Praise the Lord, everybody. I know that some of you are waiting patiently, and we've got a lot to pray about tonight. So we just really want to encourage you to tag a friend, invite someone to come on over and join us tonight as we lift up all the places that are having trouble, you know, due to the snow, the winter storm, and then here in North Carolina, and I think other areas, we were hit by tornadoes, and close to home, there were some that were killed, and I'm just thankful tonight for the blessings of the Lord, for they make us rich. I tell you, God is good. He's watching over us, taking good care of us, and even in the midst of a storm, and even in whatever you're dealing with right now, I just want to encourage you tonight to know that the Bible declares that He's a present help in the time of trouble. And we can look unto the hills from which cometh our help. For our help is in the name of the Lord. Good evening to everybody that's joining us. And we just thank you for coming on. Please tag a friend, invite others. I'm waiting on you, Solid Rock. I know you're coming. Some of you surely are going to come on. And I can see that you're here. But before we do anything else, we want to pray tonight. And hey, Bobby, Minister Phillips, I appreciate all of you. We want to pray for Texas and the other areas that are hit with this winter storm, and some are without power and some are without different things, but we know that God will sustain and help us, and pray for the victims of the tornadoes early this morning, and just pray for all the different things that are happening around our land, and invite the presence of the Lord to come now and minister to those that have needs tonight. Father, in the name of Jesus, we're so grateful tonight, Lord, for the privilege we have to call on your name. Father God, we thank you that your ear is open unto our cry. We thank you, Lord God, that you see where we're at and you know what's going on all around. Father, we lift up those that have been hit by this winter storm. Many are cold, Lord. We pray for the homeless. We pray for those, oh God, that have need tonight, Lord, whether it's electricity or water. God, whatever that need may be, we ask you right now to minister and make a way, Lord. God, we thank you, Father. Lord, comfort those that are lost people tonight, God, from the tornadoes, Lord, and many are injured. God, some have lost homes. God, we know that you're able, Lord, to restore. God, we ask you tonight to anoint us. Anoint everything that we do. Let it bring glory to your name. Anoint Justin, Lord. Anoint Sherry. Anoint me. Oh, God, let the things that we do be a sweet smell unto you, oh God. Oh, God, let the glory of the Lord rise upon us, oh God. Hallelujah. Let the words that we speak minister to the lives of your people. Father God, we thank you tonight. You are our present help. We thank you, Lord, that you're with us. We thank you, Lord, that you know where we're at. Oh, we honor you tonight, Lord God. Meet every need, God. Break yokes and shackles. Heal and deliver. Set free in Jesus' name. Oh, God, anoint us tonight. Touch your people across the airways. In Jesus' name. We honor you, Lord God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen. We love you. Hallelujah. We bless you. Glory to God. So we're going to start off with that old song, He Set Me Free, and I believe you might know it, so why don't you just sing with us?
He set me free, yes, he set me free.
Now, some of y'all have made some requests, and we're going to try to honor some of those tonight. So just pray for us as we move along here. We're going to sing an old song. It says, "Fill My Way with Love." So if you don't know it, it's in the red back hymnal, page number 179. Amen. So most of us grew up with the red back hymnal. I love you too, William Gainey. I miss you. Shed abroad in our hearts. So we had a request to sing He Touched Me, and we're going to do that now.
Need the Lord.
Lord, tonight. Thank God for His amazing touch. Thank God that He has touched us. Amen. Thank you, Lord God. I love you so. Thank you. Hallelujah.
Thank
you, Lord. He blessed you and brought you to His present time. Hallelujah. Thank the Lord for the touch.
Thank
the touch
you, Lord
that
God.
Comes
thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We bless Him tonight.
Thank
we magnify
you, Lord.
Him.
Thank you, Jesus.
We give
thank
Him
Lord.
Praise and honor and great glory.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Hallelujah. So we pray tonight that all of our praise will simply flow to Him.
Yes,
God bless
thank you, Jesus.
Flow to you. Flow to you. Let the river of my worship flow to you. Lord, I pray in all I do. Let the river of my worship flow to you. Like streams. Let the river of my worship flow to you. the songs of my heart rise to bless your name. Flow to you, flow to you. Let my worship flow to you, flow to you, flow to you. Let the river of my worship flow to you.
Yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
Lord, I pray in all I do, let the river of my worship flow to you like streams in the valley.
Yes.
They swell with the rain.
Yes, yes.
Let the songs of my heart rise and bless your name. Flow to you, flow to you. Let my worship flow to you, flow to you, flow to you. Let the river of my worship flow to you. Lord, I pray in all I do, let the river of my worship flow to you like the streams in the valley.
That was given last week, so just pray for us as we endeavor to sing some of these songs. And we're going to sing I Can't Even Walk Without You Holding My Hand. Amen.
What I want.
this message by this person that's going to give you $5,000 on Cash App. I'm asking you right now to report them because that's scamming and they don't need to be interrupting this program in this manner. So he's hit almost all of you that are out there, and I'm asking you to please report it because it shouldn't be happening. We all know that they scam and they do things because you're on the program. They're trying to get you to call them and do whatever. So I'm asking you tonight, please don't respond to that. And I'm trying to delete it as I can, but I can't delete it fast enough while we're trying to do the service. So I just thank God anyway, because no weapon that's formed can prosper. Hallelujah. And the Lord lets us know that we are not ignorant to Satan's devices. Glory to God. Our hope is in Him and in Him alone. Glory to God. And I'm not afraid to call it out. Because I know the enemy would like to stop the people of God. But we are not afraid and we're not intimidated. Glory to God. And we thank God for His abundant blessings. Amen. 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 Well, praise God. Well, I sang this song when I was about 15. So I'm now 69, so that tells you how old this next song is. But we had somebody last week to request that we would that I would sing it, so I'm going to do my best to try to remember it and try to sing it. But the song simply says, "My Jesus has broad shoulders." Yes. I took a long walk by the river.
Stronger than mine. He was there the first.
So we thank God that that song is still true.
Amen.
That God will be there any place and any time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's a wonderful, wonderful, good Father. Amen. So for our last song tonight, we're going to sing the old song. It simply says, Who Am I?
Just be true, I'll give to you.
Nobody like Jesus tonight. Amen. Nobody like Jesus. Hallelujah.
We bless thee, Lord.
We thank him. We thank him for his
praise
love.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Old saints used to say he didn't have to do it, but he did.
But he did. But he did.
And we're glad that he does what he promises he will do. Amen.
Lord bless his name.
We bless him tonight. Glory to God. Thank you for those of you that reported. And thank you for those of you that deleted or whatever you did, but at least thank God it stopped. Amen. We give God praise tonight. You know, my mind thinks in a lot of directions sometimes when I'm thinking about what I'm going to speak on or what I'm going to talk about. So, and tonight I just want to talk to some of you that maybe you feel like that you're just in a stagnant place and you haven't been able to move and you're just kind of stationary and you don't feel like you're making any progress. You know, I could ask you tonight, have you ever hit a speed bump or a pothole too fast?
My God.
One that you didn't know was coming up, you just kind of hit it. I've done that a few times in life. And it kind of gets your attention, and that's just the truth, because it does. You know, you can read on the internet about people that have ignored speed bumps, and they've hit them running really fast. And you can also read the damage that it created. You know, it damaged the axles, it bit body parts, and the front end alignment was thrown completely out, and yet people still continue to ignore the speed bump, and they keep hitting it until eventually the car literally just falls apart. And you know, if after you hit many speed bumps and you don't regard them, it takes a toll or an effect on you. You know, the purpose of a speed bump is to slow you down, but not permanently. It's just for your own safety. And some of the things that we deal with in life are for our benefit, not to slow us down, to stop us forever, but just to, maybe there's a lesson that we need to learn. You know, the enemy of our soul, he's the enemy of the church, and he would like to throw speed bumps at us and cause us to never move forward again. God. Are you got you thinking tonight, what's going to happen next? What are we going to do? What's going to be the outcome of all this craziness that's going on right now around us? And you know, the one thing that he'd like to do is to stop the church of the living God, the blood-bought, redeemed church of the living God. He wants to stop you. He wants you to just give up, quit. Well, I've run into too many things I can't handle. I've bumped into too many things. And it looks like my life is just falling apart. And I don't know what I'm going to do. But let me tell you, the church of the living God is alive and it's well. And we're on a forceful advance. And we are taking dominion and taking territory. And we are not going to surrender. We may be slowed up, but he cannot stop us. Hallelujah. We've made our mind up. That we're going to move forward in the name of the Lord, and we're going to keep marching onward, and we're going to keep looking upward, and we're going to run this race and hear him say, well done. Hallelujah. 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 We've not reached our final destination. And so, you know, I know there's going to be some potholes, and I know there's going to be some speed bumps along the journey. I've had a few. But Christians have to move forward in faith. You cannot just stagnate and get in one spot and just stay there. You've got to move forward in the Lord. You cannot rest on your past victories and say, well, you know, this was in the past. No, faith, now faith is right here, right now. It's not what you did yesterday. It's not even what you're going to do tomorrow, but it's what you got right now. Now faith is. If you rest on your past victories, it paralyzes you never to move forward. And you got to move forward personally and corporately in the body of Christ. I got a question for you tonight, and I'd like to ask you, what does an airplane, a bicycle, and a church have in common? Got any answers? Y'all got any faith? Y'all got any answers tonight for me? Well, if either of them stops moving forward, you're in trouble. If an airplane stops going forward, we're in trouble. If you're on a bike and it stops moving forward, you're in trouble. You're going to fall over. And the church of the living God must continue to move forward. I reckon recognize that we have experienced a lot of things in 2020 that we've never experienced before. I also recognize that 2021 is doing whatever people will allow it to do. But I'm here to tell you the Bible decrees that He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. And God is still with us. God is still for us. And He's still working within us. So make your mind up, beloved, that you are going to continue to move forward. Hallelujah. We're not, the Bible says when you put your hand to the plow, you're not supposed to look back. Glory to God, remember Lot's wife. That's what the scripture says. So I'm here to tell you there's nothing behind you. Glory to God, whatever's behind you, where you failed, where you messed up, where you had great victories, that's all in your past. But our God is in our present, right here and right now. God is with us. Hallelujah. Glory to God, He'll be with you tomorrow, but He's with you right now. So you've got to make your mind up. Whatever I've encountered, and whatever, how many speed bumps I've hit, no matter how many potholes I've run through, I yet know my Redeemer lives. I yet know that He's with me. I yet know He's making a way for me. I yet know, glory to God, that He's called me to move forward. And I must get up, and I must go, hallelujah, and do the will of the Father. You have to make your own mind up. So Exodus 14 and 15 says, "And the Lord said unto Moses,
Yes.
Wherefore criest thou unto me? Speak unto the children of Israel that they go forward."
Wow.
Now I recognize that forward is not often what people think about, but I'm here to tell you, you cannot become stagnant in your relationship and in your walk with the Lord.
Yes.
You've got to keep your eyes looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of your faith. It's not what's behind you, but it's what He's got prepared in front of you. Glory to God, and there's great things, and there's mighty things that He wants to reveal to us, His people. But if we're just standing on the couch and we say, well, que sera, sera, whatever will be, you're not exercising your faith muscle, and you're not exercising the power and the authority that God has placed in you as a believer, and you're not using the Word of God to advance you in the kingdom. Hallelujah, glory to God, dust yourself off, arise and get up and say, I've laid here long enough, I've been counted out too long, but I'm getting up from this place, and I'm moving forward in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. For 40 years they wandered around that mountain, wandered and wandered and wandered, but after a while it come time they had to turn and go a different way. You need to make your mind up. Glory to God, when Moses brought the children of Israel out of Egypt, now they're in a dire need. The river, the water is in front of them, the Red Sea, and behind them are the around them are the mountains, and behind them they hear the hoofs of the army coming to get them. And at that moment, I'm sure they felt overwhelmed. At that moment, they felt like they were outnumbered. At that moment, they wondered where God was. But let me tell you, know you not that He's in you. Know you not that He's working for you. Know you not that He'll make a way where there seemeth to be no way. So I say, arise and shine, for the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. And make your mind up. I'm not going to lay down. I'm not going to quit. I'm not going to give up. I'm going to stand firm and decree and declare what thus saith the Lord.
Yes, ma'am.
You can never please the Lord without faith. Hebrews 11:6 says, without faith it's impossible to please Him. And that if, when you come to Him first, you must believe that He is. That He is what? That He is God. And that He is a rewarder of them that diligently seek Him. So, you know, without faith, it's impossible to please Him. And I know Moses must have been feeling some kind of way when the Lord told him, stop crying to Him. He said, stop your crying and speak to the people. And not only, you know, He gave Moses, hallelujah, some instruction. Hallelujah. Ain't that good to know that He will give us instruction too? The Bible says in Psalms 32 and 8, I will instruct thee and teach thee in the way which thou shalt go. I will guide thee with mine eye. Hallelujah. He has not left you here to be ignorant and not left you here to not know what to do. He said, I will instruct thee and teach thee. Hallelujah. In order to move forward, sometimes we need instructions.
Amen.
But you know, you won't ever receive instruction from God if you don't believe God. You got to take God at his word. Stop crying and moaning over spilt milk is what I like to say. Some people are still living in something 30 years ago and have never moved forward from that place. And you have allowed the enemy to steal and kill from you 30 years too long. Hallelujah. God, if somebody's done something wrong to you, forgive them and let it go. Hallelujah. If somebody hurt your feelings, just get over it. Wipe your eyes and get up and say, I'll let nothing separate me from the love of God. God didn't do it, and I'm going to run on. The old saint said, I'm going to run on and see what the end's going to be. Hallelujah.
Yes,
glory to God. When Moses heard God say, why you crying to me? I'm sure at that moment he felt some kind of way. But God didn't leave him without instruction. And then the next thing the Lord gave, he didn't just give him instruction. First he told him to speak to the people. That was his instruction. But then he gave him some direction. And he said, listen, lift up your rod and cast it out over the sea.
Yeah.
So he won't only give you instructions, but he will give you directions as to what move that you need to make next.
Thank you, Lord.
And that's important.
Praise God. Amen.
Proverbs 3:6 says, in all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths.
Amen.
Proverbs 16:9 says, a man's heart deviseth his way, but the Lord directeth his steps. Hallelujah. You can make all the plans you want to, but I can tell you exactly what the Lord said to me earlier. He said, maybe they need to rethink their direction. So some of you are headed one way trying to get the Lord to put his approval on what you're doing. When the Lord is saying, you need to stop and let me speak to you. Because when I give you instruction, then I will give you direction. And when I order your steps and you go the way that I'm directed, it'll be good with you. It'll be well with you. And I'll make your way prosperous. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Not only do you have to have faith and instruction and direction, but you've got to learn how to trust God. You got to trust God when you can't trace God. You got to trust God when you don't see God. You got to trust God when you don't feel God. You just got to trust God because he is God.
Amen.
Psalms 20:7 says, some trust in chariots and some in horses. But we will remember the name of the Lord our God. You can put your trust in the bank. You can put your trust in your job. You can put your trust in your friends and your families and whatever you got. You can put your trust in all that. But let me tell you, they cannot help you in some things. Only God can. Proverbs 3:5 says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not unto your own understanding. Sometimes the things the Lord may ask you to do, you just don't feel like you can do it. But the secret is trust him and do it.
Yes, Father.
Then the other thing, you know, I really want to ask you, who are you trusting tonight? Or what are you trusting? You know, when you put your money in the bank, you trust the bank to take care of your money.
Yeah.
True. When you go to the doctor, you trust the prescription that they write. True. And you say that you trust God. But he seems to be the last one we turn to.
Help us, Lord.
But tonight, I want to say this one more thing. Then you got to have some confidence.
Yes.
Proverbs 3:26, for the Lord shall be thy confidence and shall keep thy foot from being taken. So when your confidence is in God, no matter what else is falling around you,
yes,
or who else is falling around you, when your confidence is in God, you can make it. Psalms 118:8 says, it is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. I'm thankful for those that have confidence in me. I am thankful for that. But I'm here to tell you, flesh and blood and bone can fail you. You wouldn't want to. So I'm just simply saying, don't put people on pedestals. Put your confidence in God. Moses was confident that God would deliver them, and he did. I'm confident tonight that he'll deliver us. Hebrews 10 and 35 says, "Cast not away therefore your confidence, which hath great recompense of reward." Sometimes we get our confidence mixed up, and we put it in preachers, and we put it in authorities, and we just put it in places that really sometimes we shouldn't. The one that deserves your confidence is God Almighty. And he said, don't throw that confidence away, because it has great recompense of reward. It has a great payday attached to it. Proverbs 14 and 26 says, "In the fear of the Lord is strong confidence, and his children shall have a place of refuge." I've learned that if I keep my confidence in God, that he will be my refuge in the time of trouble. When the storms of life are raging, I can run to him, because the name of the Lord is a strong tower. Tonight, you need to forget about your past failures. Philippians 3 said, "Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind." So some of you need to forget some of that stuff that's behind you tonight and say to the Lord, "Help me to let these things go. And help me to put my trust back in you. Help me to forgive those that have hurt me or wounded me or betrayed me or whatever they did. Help me, God, to let that go, because you didn't do any of that." Jesus is your best friend. He sticks closer than a brother. He's the one that'll be there when all others have gone. So, you know, I have one more little remark I want to make to you tonight, and that just simply says, put it in gear and let's go. If you drive as much as I do, I feel like sometimes I live in my car. I put a lot of miles on my car. And sometimes, you know, I know the value of pushing that gas pedal. I know what it means to be on the interstate, and I get really bothered because it's one lane, you know. They say slow traffic is supposed to stay in the right-hand side. And, you know, sometimes they get in that left lane and they hold you up, they won't let you go. And I'm wanting to get past them. I want to get on down the road. And wouldn't it be wonderful if the church would get a fresh baptism in the passion and desire to please God Almighty. And just like we accelerate and mash that gas pedal so we can keep getting on down the road, that we begin to mash that prayer pedal and begin to intercede and begin to seek the face of God, and that we would stop looking behind and look ahead. You know, in your car, the rear view mirror is very small, but the front window is very big, and there's a reason for that. You cannot ever move forward as long as you keep looking behind. So you got to put your eyes on the right prize, and that prize is Jesus Christ. We must move forward. No matter what we experience in 2020, this is a new year, this is a new day, and this is a day that the Lord has made, and we must put it in gear and move on. We can't keep lingering in the same spot and keep rehearsing the same things. We've got to let go and embrace what God has for us. So tonight I challenge you, put your faith in gear. Put your trust and confidence in God and let's go. Let's please him. Let's establish his kingdom here on the earth. Let's be light and salt. Let's let him shine bright in us and through us and for us, because he loves you with an everlasting love. So tonight we're going to pray before we go. I love you. I appreciate all of you that come by to see us every week. And you're a blessing to our lives. But we want to again lift up the winter storm and those that are without heat tonight. And the temperatures are really cold. Lift up those that were affected by the tornadoes. We want to pray for Darlene and Bruce and Carol Rosa, for her eyesight, for her grandson, and also for Carol's daughter that has cancer. There's some young lady with a liver disease we have a prayer request for. We got requests for Liberia and West Africa. We want to pray for Kathleen May's daughter. And Bobby Burbridge says she has a heavy heart. And Wanda Long and all the rest of you, if you posted your prayer request and I didn't see it, trust me, we do go back through them one by one. I'd go through everyone and read them because it matters to me. So, Father, tonight in the name of Jesus, we just glorify you and we ask you to forgive us, Lord, of the places we've become stagnant. Lord, forgive us of the times, Lord, we've allowed things to cause us to quit and not move forward. Father God, anoint our eyes with eye salve tonight that we might see clearly. Anoint our ears that we might hear the voice of the Father. Anoint our mouth with a fire coal from the altar of heaven that, Lord, we might speak as your voice. Oh God, anoint our hands and our feet that we might be used for your glory in the earth. Father God, we pray tonight for Darlene and Bruce. We come against bronchitis. We come against all those things that are working in their body, Lord. We send the healing word to their home tonight. And we ask you, oh God, that you raise them up in the name of Jesus. God, we pray for Carol Rose and her grandson and their eyesight. We pray for her daughter that has cancer tonight. We curse cancer and every cell to die and go in Jesus' name. God, we lift up the young lady with liver disease. And we ask you, oh God, to give her a creative miracle tonight. We know that you're on the throne and you still hear and you answer prayer. God, we pray for Liberia tonight in West Africa. Father God, you know what's going on in that land. And we ask you to dispatch your angels to go now in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray for Kathleen May's daughter. Lord, we ask you, oh God, that you would just anoint her from the crown of her head to the soles of her feet. God, that you would touch her tonight. Oh, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let the balm of Gilead begin to anoint. Hallelujah, your people, in Jesus' name. Father, we pray for Bobby Burbage tonight. Lord, we ask you to touch that heavy heart. You know what it's all about. In Jesus' name. God, we pray for Wanda Long. In the name of Jesus, we ask you to minister to every need. Father, those tonight that are homeless are caught in this winter storm. God, we ask you, Lord, many homes are without electricity. God, that you would intervene, that you would touch and help them, God. Help the workers, oh God, as they're laboring to get the electricity back on. Oh God, let your protection be upon them. God, we pray for the families and the lives that were touched by the tornadoes. We ask you to minister to every need. Lord, there are those that are listening tonight that have needs. And only you know what they are. But I'm asking you now, stretch your hand out in their direction and minister to them. Thank you for the prayers you've already answered. Thank you for the needs you've already met. Thank you, God, for doing great and mighty things. For, Lord, you are able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or even think, according to the power that worketh in us. God, we give you glory tonight, for you are worthy of our praise. Thank you, Lord, for your people. Bless them now, in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, amen. We bless you tonight. We love you, and we pray that you would just have a wonderful week. And, you know, I don't just pray on here for you. I make a list, and I when you come before me, I pray for you. I've been praying for some of y'all that have made endeavors for businesses, and I'm asking the Lord to bless you abundantly. I pray for those of you that are seed sowers, that God would give you the increase of the harvest. God just loves us, and I'm blessed by all of you. I don't take it for granted, because you could do a lot of other things on a Tuesday night besides watch us. But we thank you for doing that. And we pray God's abundant blessings be upon you now. In Jesus' wonderful name, have a great week. See you Sunday. God bless you.